Hello, dear chess friends. This is international chess grandmaster Nadezhda Kosintseva for chesslecture.com. And today I would like to continue the discussion about the Rogozin defense. So, as I said before, this is a pretty solid system for the black side. And additionally, it promises very interesting and dynamic positions. So, let's get started. D4, knight f6. C4, e6, knight f3, d5, knight c3, and now bishop b4 entering into the Rogozin defense. So, for today I would like to analyze what is the difference between playing bishop g5 immediately or taking on d5 first and then playing bishop g5. So, most of the chess players prefer to play to take on d5 first and then play bishop g5 for some reasons, and we will try to figure out these reasons today. So bishop g5. So first of all, recall that if white plays c takes on d5 first, e takes on d5, and now bishop g5, I suggest you to play knight bd7. In the case if white plays bishop g5 immediately, I like to play h6. So now if white takes on f6, I take on f6 with the queen, transferring the position to a pretty favorable line. So instead of taking on f6, the main line here for white is to play bishop h4. And now I suggest you to take the pawn on c4, playing d takes on c4. So the one reason why this move works, it is that if white plays e4, I play g5, and after bishop g3 I can take the pawn on e4 without any possible compensation for white. So what else? If instead of playing e4, for example, white plays e3, I can play b5 using the pin of white's knight. And if white plays, for example, knight d2, I play c6, and after a4 I can play bishop b7, preparing for a takes b5 moves. I will take on c3, and after b takes on c3 I play c takes on b5, still having one pawn more. So if white plays, instead of taking on b5, plays queen f3, for example, I'm going to play a6, and in the case of knight d goes on e4, I can just play knight b goes to d7, reflecting all white's threats. So the position is pretty good for black. Let's go back for few moves. So if instead of playing e3 white plays queen a4, I should play knight c6, defending the bishop on b4, and after e3 I have tactical ideas. I can play bishop d7 with the idea after bishop takes on c4, take the pawn on d4, and white cannot take my bishop on b4 due to the fork with my knight on c2 square. So for this reason, I think the main the best move for white after d takes on c4 is to play a3. I should take on c3 now, because if I play bishop a5, white now plays queen a4, and after knight goes on c6, then they can take the pawn on c4 with the queen, and the position for white is better due to better position of their pieces. So for this reason, as I said, I should take the knight on c3, and after b takes on c3, I think the best move for black is to play c5. Why I think it is the best move? Because, for example, if black plays queen goes on d5, after bishop takes on f6, g takes on f6, and knight d2, white has the idea to play e4, and black cannot do anything against it. For example, if they play f5, I'm going to sacrifice a pawn, playing e4, f takes on e4, bishop takes on c4, queen g5, and now short castle. And due to better development of the pieces, white has more than enough compensation for a pawn. Okay, let's go back. So for this reason, after b takes on c3, I'm going to play c5. Again, the main idea of this move is to counterplay playing queen a5, knight e4, then in the future, if white allows me to do it. So after c5, maybe the better option for white is to play e3. If instead of playing e3, white plays, white decided to take the pawn back immediately, playing queen a4. After queen a4, I'm going to play knight b goes on d7, and after queen c4, just short castle, e3, for example, developing the pieces, and queen a4, pinning white's king. So, for example, if now white plays bishop goes on d3, I just take the pawn on d4, and after e takes on d4, my knight goes on d5, attacking weaknesses on the queen side. So, what else? So if after e3, queen a5, white plays knight d2, for example, with the idea to take on d4 with a pawn, with a c pawn, which is much better pawn structure, I'm going to play b5, using the fact that white cannot take my pawn on b5 because of queen c3 move. So queen b3, bishop b7, and for example, if white takes my pawn on b5, I'm going to play rook f goes on b8, again pinning white's pieces on the queen side, and I will have more than enough compensation for the pawn due to activity of my pieces. So let's go back and consider e3 move instead of queen goes on a4. So e3, queen a5. So bishop takes on f6, and now I should not take on f6 with a pawn, because after queen goes on c2, white has very good position, and they have more than enough compensation for the pawn. So instead of taking on f6, I should take on c3 first. Knight goes on d2. And now I take a bishop with my pawn. So, rook c1. Another option for white to take the pawn with a bishop. If they take my pawn with a bishop, I take another pawn on d4, and after short castle, take one more pawn on e3. And after knight goes on e4, I should be able not to take the white's bishop due to a trap, due to a fork with a knight. After knight goes on d6, so if I see this idea, I'm going to play queen e5 instead of taking the bishop. And again, there is another trap here. If white plays bishop b5, I should not take the bishop due to the same reason, because of fork with the knight. But I can just play knight c6 and I have very good position, and white does not have enough compensation for their pawns. So, for this reason, it's better to play rook c1 instead of taking the pawn on c4 with the pawn. Rook c1. I accept this sacrifice. I take the pawn on a3. Bishop takes on c4. I take on d4. Short castle. So it is a critical position of this line, and to say the truth, at the first glance, this position, the position for the black side, may seem dangerous due to some reason. First of all, it is double pawns on the king side, worse development of the pieces, and then safe king. But if we see into the position deeply, we may note that double pawns are pretty good in defending. Moreover, black actually needs only two moves, bishop d7 and knight c6, to finish the development of the queen sign. And finally, the castle is not necessary in this position for the safety of the king. And finally, the last but not least, black has 3 pawns more for now. So, it should be enough. So I play knight c6. Bishop b5. I think this move is better than taking the pawn on d4 immediately, because if white takes on d5 immediately, I play some weird move. I play king goes to f8. Actually, it is the most safest position for my king in this position, and additionally I'm going to put to occupy the g-file with my rook, and I feel pretty good about this position for the black side. Okay, for example, let's see. If white plays d5, it's very logical move. I take on d5 with my pawn, and after bishop takes on d5, I'm going to play bishop f5 with the idea to play bishop g6, king g7, and then to include my rooks into the game. So, white does not have better options than to take on c6. I take on c6 with a pawn, rook takes on c6. I'm going to play king g7, as I said. And, for example, after knight goes on c4, attacking my queen, I play queen d3, queen a1, attacking my pawn on f6, I play bishop e6, and for example, after knight d6, I can play rook ih goes on b8, and now I have only 1 pawn more, but still my position is good enough. I have a bishop, I have all my pieces developed already, and so I don't think that I have any problems in this position. So let's go back and analyze bishop b5 instead of taking on d4 immediately. So I played knight c6 and bishop b5. So I play bishop d7, defending my knight on c6. Knight goes on e4, attacking my pawn on f6. And I just play queen e7. So what now? If white plays, for example, knight c5, I can play a6, bishop a4, b5, and after bishop b3, I can just take another pawn on e3 and goes, and my knight goes on e5. Again, I still safe position. I have a lot of pawns more, and I really like my position. So, for this reason, it's better to take, finally to take the pawn on d4. White takes the pawn on d4. And again, I play king goes on f8. Again, as I said, this move is very important in this position. The black side does not need to castle at this position because I'm going to occupy g file with my rook and I'm not going to spend a lot of time. So, rook e1. The idea of this move is to prepare d5 move. Immediately d5 was not so good because if white plays d5, I takes on d5 with my pawn, and after queen takes on d5, I play rook d8 with the idea to play with my bishop, and again I have safe position and 2 pawns more. So I played king f8. Okay. If white plays knight c5 at this position instead of d5 or rook e1, I'm going to play bishop e8. And again, I reflected all white's threats, and again, I feel safe about my position. Okay. King f8, rook e1, preparing d5 move. So now I play f5, and after knight c5, bishop e8. So now black needs only one move to centralize the pieces. This move is to play rook d8. So now white cannot wait longer and they should play immediately d5. I play rook d8, pinning the white's queen. So white should take my pawn on b7. I take the pawn on d5, and after queen takes on d5, e takes on d5, rook takes on d5, knight takes on d5, I should take with my knight because my knight on c6 is hanging and I cannot do it with my king. So bishop takes on e8, I take with my king. Rook c8, these moves are very logical for both sides. And I play king f8, preparing to knight d6 check. And my next move, for example, white plays knight d6, I'm going to play rook g8, finally entering my another rook into the game. And after rook takes on a7, rook g6, position is about equality. I still have 1 pawn more, but I don't think that I will be able to realize this advance, and because I have double pawns first of all, and white have enough compensation due to activity of their pieces. So, but still the position is about equality, and it is the best what the white can do in this position. So, summarizing our today lecture, I would like to say that the main difference between bishop g5 line and taking on d5 first and then playing bishop g5 line, it is the additional option for black to take the pawn on c4, giving arm some initiative, but still having pretty solid position and more pawns. So I suggest you to practice this position, and I hope you enjoy today's lecture. It was Nadezhda Kosintsova for chesslecture.com.